school down coming.
A lot of stuff on the way. Our quiet weather is about to change. We are back in the storm track. And yeah, you might say that autumn is about to turn ornery. That's right. It took me a while to think of that, guys. Now, come on. Give me a little break. Showers, thunder, and mountain snow on the way to New Mexico. And wicked weekend wind. I know you didn't want to hear it, but that's what we're going to be dealing with. This is the good news. Some snow, especially for the higher terrain. Southwest Colorado, the San Juans, 4 to 8 inches of snow. This is a winter weather advisory that goes through tomorrow. I believe it will be extended and probably expanded into northern New Mexico. A wind advisory, northeast Arizona, where we can see wind gusts to 45 miles per hour, and Arizona's not alone. The storm track is diving into New Mexico, and that's going to direct a couple of storm systems our way, tracking it with future Track 7. By lunchtime tomorrow, already showers popping up around Silver City, the Gila, the southern areas of New Mexico, expanding. By the drive time home, we'll see some of those showers and embedded thunderstorms across maybe the Albuquerque, Santa Fe areas. Not everybody will see rain, but we have a chance of showers, and those showers could have some very gusty winds. And you see the white and blue representing the snow across the northern mountains from the San Juans into the Sangre de Cristos, the Jemez Mountains, all the way through Saturday. So how much snow? Who could see a foot? How about the Sangre de Cristos? Well, it looks more like around the San Juans. This darker shade of blue represents up to a foot of snow. So from near Chama up into the Pagosa area, we could see that. And the pink represents where we could see over a foot of snow. And you see around Red River, Angel Fire, into the Taos Ski Valley. Even the Santa Fe ski area seeing some snow. Pajarito, a chance of snow. That's all the way through Saturday. The wind, a big story. We talked about the wicked weekend wind tomorrow, turning windy. Central western areas, even into the east, and watch what happens as we go into Saturday. I think that will be the windiest day on Saturday. We could see potentially damaging winds along and east of the central mountain chain. Sustained winds maybe in excess of 40 to 45, maybe 50 miles per hour. So that could create some big time problems. Digging out of the deep freeze in the northeast, causing some problems for some sea turtles. I'll have more on that coming up in the second half hour. 56 in New York City for tomorrow, 56 Boston, looking at 61 in the Mile High. Back to the west, 62 in San Fran. LA sounds nice, near 70 degrees. Farmington, the Four Corners, not 70 tomorrow, but we're going to have a chance of showers and thunderstorms, a lot of wind around too, and high elevation snows. Those snow levels will be coming down tomorrow night into Saturday, so that's where we'll really begin to pick the snow up across the San Juans. Into the southwestern parts of the state, you saw with future track 7, those showers popping up by the lunch hour. Silver City, Lordsburg, TRC, a lot of whipping wind, maybe areas of blowing dust with those showers and storms. Southeast New Mexico around Carlsbad, looking at breezy to windy conditions tomorrow, stronger winds, areas of blowing dust on Saturday. In the northeast, you're going to deal with the strong winds, Raton, Las Vegas, into Taos, and once again, that snow developing for the higher elevations around Red River for late tomorrow and tomorrow night. Taos, a chance of showers and thunderstorms. Santa Fe, tonight we're going to dip down to 31, 55 in the plaza tomorrow. A chance of showers and thunderstorms and breezy and windy by Saturday. Bernalillo, Rio Rancho, Los Lunas, and Belen after 30s tonight. Maybe some patchy fog. We'll see highs in the 60s, but breezy to windy tomorrow. 38 for the Heights, 31 for the Valley. Slight chance of patchy fog. And tomorrow turning breezy with that chance of showers and thunderstorms late. Windy on Saturday. If you're heading out to the Lobos game, keep that in mind. Gust to 40 miles per hour, slight chance of spot storms, and it does turn cooler, jacket weather, by Sunday. But yeah, big changes on the way. Our quiet stretch is saying see ya.
All right, Byron.